Hello everyone.
This compatible numbers and rounding off.
These all are the keywords, compatible numbers and round off. So you have to rounding off. You have already learned in your third standard itself. Have you all remembered that? Okay, now we are going to just recall it and we move on to compatible numbers. So rounding off helps to work on large numbers more easily. It is easier to work with numbers such as 1000, 10,000, lakhs, okay, 500 like that, because it has more zeros. So we can add or we can subtract easily. So these numbers have zeros at the end. Compatible numbers together give a rounded off number. Okay, what is mean by compatible number? So the compatible numbers which add up to form a rounded number are called compatible numbers. Again I repeat, numbers which add up to form a rounded number are called compatible numbers. Okay, these are also known as friendly numbers. Compatible numbers are used to add or subtract quickly. Okay, we will see one example, then you can understand easily. Okay, look at the number 678. Now we are going to rounding off this number nearest to 100. Okay. So 678 plus 22. Then I got 700. So I got the answer 700. So here I added 22, isn't it? To get the rounding off number. So the numbers which add up to form a rounded number are called compatible numbers. So here 22 is a compatible number, because the 22 only I added to form a rounded number. So the 22 is called as compatible. So compatible number is also known as friendly numbers. It helps us to do mental math. So we'll see some examples. Okay, when we rounding off 8 nearest to 10, we have to add 2. So 8 plus 2, we get 10. So here 2 is the compatible number. The same way, when we rounding off 75, we have to add 25. So 25 is the compatible number. The same way 7. When we rounding off 7 nearest to 10, we have to add 3. So 3 is the compatible number. The same way 55,000. Okay, now we are going to rounding off the 55,000 nearest to 1 lakh. So for that we have to add 45,000. Then only we get 1 lakh. So that 45,000 is also known as compatible number. Then 9,900 and 100. Okay, when we add 100 to the 9,900, we get 10,000. So that 100 is called as compatible number. So and also 8,000 and 2,000. When we add 2,000 with 8,000, we get 10,000. So here 2,000 is a compatible number. So these are all the example for compatible numbers. Rounding off rule. This one also we have already learned. Now we are going to just recall it. Numbers should be rounded to the next place value when the given place value is more than 5. Okay. The given place value is more than 5. We have to round the next place value. Otherwise, should be rounded to the last place value. So, if the number is less than 5, we have to round down. When the units or when the number is less than 5, you have to round down. When the number is greater than 5 or equal to 5, okay, we have to round up. Also, keep it this in your mind. Okay, we will see one example for rounding down. Look at the number 12,450. Now we are going to rounding off this number nearest to 1000. So you have to check the number in 100 place. Okay, when we rounding off the 1000 place value, we have to check the number of 100 place value. So here 4 less than 5, isn't it? So the answer is 12,000. No need to add anything, okay? The last place value you have to write. Look at the number 12,650. The same way, now we are going to rounding off this number nearest to 1000. So look at the 100 place value here, 6. 6 is greater than 5. So the answer is 13,000, because look at the number line here. Here the 12,450 and 12,650, the both numbers comes in between 12,000 and 13,000. If the number is less than 5, you have to choose the lowest number. So 12,000. If the number is greater than 5, you have to choose the biggest number here. So that is 13,000. So when the number is less than 5, you have to choose the lowest number. If the number is greater than or equal to 5, you have to choose the largest number here. Okay, our example 1. Round off 36,000 to the nearest 10,000. So first, we have to write the place value. 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000. Because now we are going to round off this number nearest to 10,000. No? So except 10,000, the all other numbers should be 0. Okay, when we rounding off this number nearest to 10,000 means except 10,000, the all other digits should be 0. So we are going to convert all the other digits to 0. So here, what is the highest place value here in the marked area? That is 1000. Okay, this 13,000 comes in between 30,000 and 40,000. So 30,000 plus 4,000, we get 40,000, isn't it? That 6 is also greater than 5. So that 4,000 is a compatible number. That 6 is greater than 5. So we have to choose the bigger number here. That is 40,000. Okay. We will see next example. Round off 14,450 to nearest 10,000. Sorry, 1000. So round off 14,450 to nearest 1000. So the first step, you have to write the place value. 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000. The next step, here 1000, no? So except 1000. After 1000, all digits should be 0. So this 14,450 comes in between 14,000 and 15,000. Okay. Now we are going to check the place value, that is 100. Because look at the marked area. Look at the circled area, 450. Now here you have to check the first, that is 100 place value. So that is 4 less than 5. So which number you have to choose? Lower number or higher number? So that is the lower number you have to choose. So 4,450 is rounded off to 14,000. Okay.